Thanks, Michelle. That was great. Hey, y'all. How you doing? What? Is LA in the house over there? Is that what? Oh, no. That was Carolyn Helmke. Nice. I'm Seleta Reynolds. I'm the general manager for Los Angeles Department of Transportation. I'm also very lucky to be president of the board for NACTO, and I'm so excited to welcome you to Chicago and again emphasize that there are 800 of us this year. This is the biggest NACTO Designing Cities conference to date, and it would be bigger, but the Chicago Fire Department wouldn't let us have any more people in here, so whatever, life safety. But I did want to say, Corinne Kisner, who deserves a round of applause for her work on the conference and her leadership, asked me to give my reflections on the past year. And I was like, great, reflections on what NACTO has done. And she goes, no, your reflections on what's going on in the world over the last year. And I said, well, Corinne, come on. How could you possibly sum up how complicated and the highs and the lows of the last year in a sort of a time of what I'll politely call alternative facts? I thought that maybe it would be good to focus on some things that are true. And the first thing that is true, without question, is that cities get stuff done. And the same night that we had a presidential election, no matter how you felt about it, cities around the country and municipalities around the country passed over $200 billion with a B dollars for transportation funding in the United States, which is a huge accomplishment and a testament to where cities are thinking and what cities are thinking about. The second thing that is true is that no matter what you care about, no matter what you want to work on, transportation in cities is the place to be. It has long been the place to be if you care about public health, if you care about economic development, if you care about saving lives, if you care about livability, if you care about sustainability. But in this past year, it also was very clearly a place to work if you care about things like resistance, if you care about things like protest. You could see people gathering and coming together mostly on infrastructure, transportation infrastructure in cities. A big part of my job became making sure that people in Los Angeles had a place to safely come together, to express themselves, to demonstrate, to exercise their First Amendment rights. And that's a very powerful thing to be able to do from the vantage point of a transportation department. If what you care about is racial equity and social justice, hopefully last year you were inspired by Tamika Butler's remarks and have had a chance to see her remarks at the Vision Zero conference, where she continues to implore and inspire us to do our best work by knowing and seeing that transportation can be big enough to take on issues that maybe seem larger and overwhelming, and can and should be a place to continue to convene conversations in a civil way across a table, over coffee, in a neighbor house, at a community meeting, and in your own offices. And that's really the power of transportation. And the last thing that I'll say that's true about transportation that I hope you will take and think about quite a bit is that transportation is a women's issue. In Los Angeles, about a quarter of women and girls live in poverty, and about 30% of those don't have a high school diploma. And a lot of that is a direct outcome, and I place the burden of that on a transportation system that locks people's opportunity, that really confines their world, that keeps them away from education, from jobs, and from growth. And that's the opportunity we have before us, to think about not just the needs of the 9-to-5 white-collar workers on our streets, but to think about the women and families in our cities, to think about how to deal and really not just connect people to opportunities, but make places. That's our opportunity. And I hope that you can take what you learn here, go back to wherever you are, and put your head down and really get stuff done. The next thing that I want to talk about and that I think is important to acknowledge is the fact that these things are only possible in cities with great leadership. And really the capital that exists and our commissioners and our of transportation and their staff is really the thing that lifts us all up and gets us all to accomplish more. So today, I'm very, very proud to announce the launch of our new leadership development program, Leadership NACTO. And this is something that's been a long time in coming, and all of us sort of know about leadership instinctually. But I think it's important, some of you know that before I took on the job that I had now, the largest number of people that I had managed was 20. And now I manage 2,000. And I would not have been able to step into that role without the professional development, investment in leadership, mentoring, sponsoring, coaching, and championing that I had from many of the people in this room. From a champion like Jeanette Sadiq Khan, who recruited me for the job and who hung with me afterwards, always took my phone calls, and would always listen to me over many, almost said bottles, glasses of wine, which was invaluable to me. And without Matt Henry, who's the president of Farron Pierce, taking me out to many lunches and telling me that, yes, I could do this. And without Scott Kubley, who is the director of the Seattle Department of Transportation, being an ally and having many long conversations with me as he was walking home from the office and I was on the bus and we were talking about what in the world we had gotten ourselves into and sharing our challenges and struggles with each other. And I want everybody who is ready and able and willing and ambitious enough to step into these roles to find that same network for yourselves. And that's really what Leadership NACTO is about. It's about building a cohort of peers. It's about connecting to mentors and champions and sponsors who can lift up the next generation of commissioners in our NACTO cities. So it's a 9-month fellowship program in 2018. It is open to staff of NACTO member cities and transit agencies. And the application period officially opens today. So you can visit NACTO.org/leadership to learn more and apply, and I hope that many of you will do so that we can get this going and get people excited, and it can be a new tradition that creates many, many generations of great leaders in our cities. So next, I want to announce that we have 14 new NACTO members this year. Great year for NACTO. And actually, 4 of them are transit agencies. It's worth mentioning and recognizing the great work of Matt Rowe on the Transit Accelerator Program that we've done in Denver and Oakland and Cambridge and Indianapolis. And we are so excited to bring transit agencies into our membership at NACTO. So as I call your name, if you're here, please stand up and remain standing so that everybody knows you're new and we can all reach out and befriend you. So Alex, welcome to Alexandria, to Charleston, to Chattanooga Area Regional Transportation Authority, to the Chicago Transit Authority. Thank you, Dorval, for being here. Yep. To Fort Collins, to Halifax. Look at Canada showing up. Long Beach, to LBC, to LA Metro. Very proud of LA Metro. Orlando, happiest place on earth. Raleigh, North Carolina. San Antonio, and VIA, the transit agency, West Palm Beach, and Vancouver TransLink. Let's give them a round of applause. Welcome. We are so glad you're here. So one of the other traditions at NACTO is that we do like to engage in a little friendly competition. And I like to think that the cities of Los Angeles and Chicago have sort of a playful relationship. Last year, for example, Chicago won the World Series. Round of applause for that. This year, not as successful, but we can't brag just yet. And this year, Chicago and Los Angeles were finalists for the very first Vision Zero Leadership for Youth Award given out by the National Center for Safe Routes to School. And that is because Chicago and Los Angeles have two of the oldest Safe Routes to School policies in the country. So we were very, very proud to receive this award this year. We had over 48,000 kids, 280 schools participate in Los Angeles this year, and we wish Chicago best of luck for next year. But we really do hope that NACTO is a place for us to push each other through friendly competition to go farther and faster than we would have on our own.